Actually, I was really excited because I think it's a wonderful material, you know, to be able to showcase something that everyone's so interested in. It's like the media, what goes on behind the scenes, and you know, between the actors, the you know, I mean, those in the office, and what goes on between like EPs and AVPs and all that. So I thought that was really interesting. And then they told me that I would be playing an actress. I was thinking, okay, well, how much different could it be? But then when I read the script, I was really very, very excited because she's different. She's someone who's trying to struggle her way to the top. She's been acting for 3 years. Nobody knows her. Can't even call out her name. And she's just, you know, working really hard, but she's not given a chance. And she's been molded by the situations and circumstances around her. Her superiors are telling her that, you know, to move up the ladder, you have to, you know, play some games. You need to be a little bit more scheming. You need to do things. And at first, I was a bit like, you know, I wasn't sure if I should do that until I started to get bullied. You know, there is an Ati in the show, and Donyo plays that character. And she's always like bullying me. She teams up with this director to like really torture me. And she steps on me, she injures me and all that. So all these things make me want to like push myself up so that, you know, nobody's ever going to do this to me again. So I thought that this was a very interesting role to play. She's very flawed. She's got her flaws. She does wrong things. She makes wrong decisions. But in the end, I feel that she's a very real character because, you know, we are all subjected to the environment, the situations around us, and we all react because of all these things. And I think that, you know, the way that she's made, she's actually a very good girl. She's actually very kind. She just wants to take care of her family, her grandfather, and that's really her main aim in life. And because of all these things, all these factors around her, it makes her into someone very different. So yeah, I really love this character. When I first entered the industry, I was a very yes-no kind of person. And I always wanted to protect my own private life. And I thought that, okay, if I just said yes or no, it would be fine, you know. But everyone was telling me that, no, you should share a bit more, you should share a bit more. I think that to this day, I've still been able to protect, you know, whatever that is important to me, whatever is private to me. But I've been able to open up a lot more, to share a lot more things, a lot more of my thoughts and all that. And I think that it's become a lot easier for everyone. But there are, of course, people who tell me that you're too low profile, you should do something so that people see you more. But I feel that that's not me. And I think I'm happy the way it is now. You know, I feel very comfortable that, you know, I can protect this privacy, and that people are also, you know, that the media has also come to accept the person for who I am. Yeah, so it's good. It's all good now. I would say initially, I think they all kind of worried when they saw my name that they had to interview me because they knew that I was a boring subject. You know, it's like there's nothing coming out of her, there's no news, there's nothing, she's not going to spill the beans on anything. So to a lot of them, it's like, oh no, Ocean's so boring. But I think over the years, it's kind of changed because they come to know me more, you know, and they've come to accept the person for who I am. And I guess also now I'm more confident to share my thoughts. So it's not so much like, oh no, what's the next question gonna be? So I better stop here before they ask something else, you know, what else are they gonna dig out of me? But I think it also comes from knowing that in Singapore, the media is really very safe. You know, you don't have like paparazzi, you don't have people waiting out of your house, you know, like trying to take photos of you. And even when I go out for a meal, I think it's safe. You know, I don't feel so worried. And I think that my confidence comes from there as well. You know, I don't need to worry about like, you know, like weird photos coming out. Yes. Yes. And I think it's kind of scary because there was once when I came out of the station and there was a car that was stalking me and was like following me all the way home. But I stopped by the petrol station and then my assistant actually got out and walked towards them and they sped off. And there have been a few sightings of them following me everywhere during filming, even though we've got like, you know, like very weird locations and it's like hard to find. They followed me to Malaysia and China. Yeah, but whenever we look over or we want to walk up to them, you know, they run away. So I don't know. I think that, you know, if they actually, like, you know, just talk to me or anything, I would feel better. You know, I wouldn't be so afraid. And I think the only other thing is also like when we are eating or like when I'm eating outside, sometimes people like to take photos. I think that's the downside of having camera phones. Yeah, so they'll like take photos and they'll like, you know, secretly take. But the funny thing is they think that you don't know, but it's actually so obvious. And I think that, I know, it's like, I don't know, and it's like you're stuffing your face with food, and how pretty can that picture be? So I think that, I mean, I don't mind you coming up to me to ask me for a photo. I think that's something that I really appreciate. Yeah. It was this time when I bought a present, and I wanted it gift wrapped. And then after that, I decided that, no, I think I'd rather wrap the present myself. So I told the staff, no, I don't think I'll get the wrapping paper. And then he said something like, well, you cannot even afford wrapping paper, it's only $120. And then I was like, it's not a matter of wrapping I'm not buying this wrapping paper. And then I was so angry because I felt that you were rude. And I think that it's not the whole point of this $120 thing. And then after that, I kind of just reasoned it out with him. And I think I was quite fierce. And then after that, I think my friend was telling me that, oh no, what's he going to say about you? But I think that there are certain things that you just need to put your foot down on. You know, it's like, it doesn't mean that, you know, people can push you around because you're a celebrity and you can't speak up for yourself. I think that there are certain things that, you know, and for me, I really can't take rude people. So yeah, I'll tell them off. Yeah, so...